Hi folks, I'm Matt and welcome to My Expanded Universe, a show where I go through the entire EU in chronological order as best I know how. Folks, it's time to go and talk about the next book in the Legacy of the Force series written by Karen Travis, and it's called Revelation. In this series, Jaina starts training under Fett, Boba Fett, because she needs to learn every trick in the book as she's going to go off and fight Jason. It's all been decided that she's going to be the one. I think we all know how this is going to end. So Jaina's trying to learn as many things as she can. And of course, the way of the Mando is like a sacred martial art. So she's learning every trick in the book from Fett, and Fett's teaching her. Now, of course, as you notice, Fett is really prevalent in Karen Travis's book because she's really trying to curry favor with the fans who are at this point really pissed at her. Again, I don't really like how Karen Travis writes Fett, but that may be just me. Meanwhile, things aren't going well for Jason. Admiral Nathal and Pelion finally decide enough is enough, and they turn on Jason, basically take most of the fleet with them. Now remember, at this point, Tenel Ka has already withdrawn her Hapen fleet, so Jason is quickly losing power. So he still has some followers, he still has an army, and he's turning on them, and he's going to crush them, both of these traitors to the Alliance. In fact, he sends Tahiri to assassinate Pelion. And I remember this. Pelion, I think, is 92 at the time of his death, or 93. He's already a really old man. But he sees Tahiri, he knows why she's there, and you know as a reader, this is it. She's going to kill him. I knew immediately that this was going to happen. And Pelion does too, and he does the right thing. He knows why she's there. He basically gives his speech, and he goes out on a high note, in my opinion. Pelion's death really isn't talked about that much. Pelion was a great character. He lived a very long life. I have no memory of Timothy Zahn even saying anything about Pelion dying. I don't think he was upset at all, or if he has been, I've never heard him say anything otherwise. Pelion lived a grand old life. He has a great legacy. He had a card up his sleeve, by the way, this whole time, as he would, as any student of Grand Admiral Thrawn would, is that he has contacted Admiral Dalla, and Admiral Dalla suddenly comes to the rescue, a little late for Pelion, but she comes to the rescue with a bunch of Mandos because it's a Karen Travis story, and they save the day. They turn the tide against the battle against Jason. And in a way, this is also setting up something that is going to happen later on in the series. Admiral Dalla, once again, she has fallen on her face so many times, yet now she's looking good. She wins a big victory. It's going to be memorable to everyone out there in the galaxy, and it's going to elevate her position once again. Just wait and see. And of course, like I said, I hated Admiral Dalla when she first came out in Kevin J. Anderson's book. I just hated her because she was terrible. She always failed. Yeah, that was the point. She always fails, but then she gets back up and comes back harder the next time and gets better. And she elevates her position every time she does it. So keeping with that, here comes Dalla after a little hiatus. She's back into the storyline, saves the day, and has come back in a big way, which is really going to benefit her later on. Now, I was going to mention what happens to Dalla later on, but I forgot. That's in the next series where she will fall again in a way. It's beautiful. But I digress. Let's get back to the Jedi. What are the Jedi doing right now? Well, they're doing something really nice for Boba Fett. They are healing his wife. That's right, Sintas Vale. I've kind of kept this a secret, but I may as well talk about it now. She is alive. Boba Fett did not know, but sadly, because of, I believe it's carbonite, prolonged carbonite imprisonment. How ironic is that? She has lost her vision, kind of, it looks like permanently. You know how Han kind of lost his vision for a little little while, slow to return. Well, she's been in carbonite for so long, it seemed like it was permanent. Also, her memories are messed up too after being encased in carbonite for so long. But the Jedi healers are able to heal her. She's able to be with Fett again. And again, I don't really, the Sentos Vale Fett storyline, that they're in love or something, I just don't get that. I mean, yes, Boba Fett's getting old. You want to give him a happy ending, I guess. But to me, it just, I didn't really like it. A lot of the things that Karen Travis does, to me, feels like she's pandering to the fans. Like, don't you love Fett? Here's some more Fett. Here, I'll spoon feed you some more Fett. Fett's training Jaina. Don't you like Jaina? Here, take another bite. Oh, don't worry. Sentos Vale is better now. I made her all better. Now she and Boba Fett can be in love. Take another bite. I really don't like the way she tells stories. That's what I mean by pandering. I mean, probably she doesn't do that. But that's every time I read a book, that's what I feel like Karen Travis was trying to do here. And in my opinion, out of the three authors, she was obviously, in my opinion, the weakest of the three. I think Aaron Alston and Troy Denning were aces for every book. And Karen Travis's felt a little flat each time. But that's just me. All right, folks, that's it for now. See you next time with another heavy-hitting book.